Vi har nyheten att det svenska succébandet Swedish House Mafia lägger ner.
Swedish House Mafia have today announced their breakup.
They put a thing up on their website saying it was no more.
Axwell, Steve Angelo and Sebastian Ingrosso.
That their next tour is their final one.
I don't know. We all love them. I don't know why they would end it.
Det är löjligt.
Absolut.
De borde fortsätta. De kan bli bättre.
Gotta move on. Gotta make new things.
Maybe they'll rejoin. Who knows?
Vad är planen? Det är en stor turné.
Ja, vi är en jättestor världsturné nu. Det är väl det som är planen just nu.
Vad ska du göra efter? Vad är det som tanken?
Vi kommer väl alla fortsätta våra solokarriärer och fortsätta göra musik som vanligt.
Men är det blivit ovänner eller är det någon problem?
Nej.
How is it gonna work? If it is like this, you know, it's like, it's not gonna work.
Det är skönt att göra musik samtidigt som man gör sig klar. Då lyssnar man lite så här halvpassivt bara.
Det fetaste tycker jag är när beatet kommer in och sen pausar det direkt. Sen bara, det här har precis kommit igång liksom. Det är fett. Och sen så kommer den igen här liksom. Det är bara sjukt.
Nytvätten, som det kallas. Jag kom hit med 5 t-shirtar kvar. Och nu liksom har jag tvättat typ allt. Ja, 16 t-shirts har vi nu.
Jag känner mig bara så här, den här t-shirten och bara... Jag känner sig så här fet och svullen och bara... Fan, jag har inte ens en hoodie, ingenting med mig. Skum. Jag känner mig inte bekväm. Vänta. Vad fan, alltså. Får inte glömma vigselringen. Wow. Vad är det av ciggen nu då?
Tickets to their one last tour. 50 shows in 26 countries.
They
bara just att komma in i den här turnén liksom. Man måste komma in och vara uppvärmd och...
There are obviously reasons to why they're breaking up the band. I mean, how are they going to keep it together for that whole world tour?
Leave the world behind ya. Swedish House Mafia just sold out Madison Square Garden in 9 minutes.
Hi, Joe, it's JoJo on the radio in the studio with the Swedish House Mafia.
They look, they're just unique from anything else in the industry. And they made house music popular.
They'll say two minds are better than one. Well, how about three minds, you know? It, like, puts you in a good mood, lifts your spirits up.
Their own individual styles, the way they've come together as a group.
They're so excited.
The stage is built of 26 Kinesis motors that are holding up three flying video screens.
Two in the front, one in the back, so it pushes all the energy out front where all the people are. They're very powerful.
That's a lot of laser.
Yeah, it says about 800 LED panels on there.
That's so bright.
It's probably the most elaborate pyrotechnics these guys have ever had in any tour.
These are the PRG Bad Boys. We have three, one for each guy on stage.
It's going to be an assault on all senses.
Det är så jävla viktigt att vi liksom levererar det absolut fetaste som vi någonsin kan. För det är på sätt och vis det fetaste vi någonsin har gjort.
Single from the Swedish House Mafia, eagerly awaited. It's called Don't You Worry, Child.
D'Angelo has arrived. Walk in front of us, over.
Visst är det litet?
Skojar du?
Är det bra?
Det är stort, fast ändå liksom...
Fast intimt.
Ja, men det känns naturligt stort på något vis. Så här, ja, men det är klart. Det känns inte så bara... Åh! Liksom... Det var ju lite så.
Wait. Before it drops, what happened there? What happened with the lights and the turn? Is it cause something?
Well, you're always gonna hear a different mix.
Oh, I know. We need some dun dun, take a duke back, a duke, pick a dun. Something. It looks kind of dead there.
Let's do it.
De här gillar jag mest, för då ser man hur stort det är. Kolla nu.
Time.
We gotta run.
Came from California.
See you tonight. Yeah. Awesome, cool, man.
Min psykolog bara försöker underhålla dig från stress och sådär och liksom ta det lugnt de här dagarna.
Beginning of the end. What emotions are going through all of you?
I don't really think of it as an end. Now it feels like a beginning of something.
We'll be right back.
these parts with your best friends and just having fun and explore playing the biggest venues around the world. This is a dream come true.
I'm looking forward to like hanging out, really, with all of the guys. I'm sure we're gonna have some fun.
I'm just happy we're traveling the world together and that we're gonna see this and we're gonna do this once and for all, you know, just go out with a bang and just do this.
De finns i mitt hjärta, i mitt blod, allting.
Swedish House Mafia, det går inte att de lägger ner.
Hej, glad Fia.
Men gå igenom det så kan jag vinka av dig. Hej.
Pappa älskar dig. Hej då, hej då. Så.
Jag får leka.
Hej då, morsan. Hej då. Okej.
What do you want for Christmas? Klocka.
Jag vill ha en klocka på min pappa.
Vill du ha en sån pappa har klocka?
Jag vill ha en pappa.
You want it in black? Okay. Same size? Va?
Diamond.
Vad ska jag sjunga? Ska jag sjunga opera?
Mm. Som jag sjunger i bilen.
Som jag sjunger i bilen. Det var van hemlis.
Pappa, kom igen nu!
Kom
igen nu, sockis! Kom igen då,
okay, vänta då.
Pappa, kom igen nu, din latmask.
Leon!
Okej, tack!
Varsågod. Bra. Mm. Vi ses när jag kommer hem.
Mm.
Okay. That's good.
But in the end of the tour, we're gonna quit this. One last cigarette I'm gonna have.
Miami will take a whole pack.
I don't have a lighter. My tools. Next My father started a record company, 89, Plump House and Loop Records. They released a lot of deep tech house, techno, acid house. I fell in love with the energy and the intense, you know, the whole like, oh my God, what's happening? Something happened to my body. You know, with the beats coming in and the bass drum and the tombs and everything building up to something that I never heard before. And it was something new. I felt that someday people will feel this. People will love this, because I can't be wrong. So my mission was to find other people doing what I did. I'm gonna tell you how I met Steve. He was a DJ, he was a hip-hop DJ. You know, we would hang out with the same people and we grew in, you know, to each other. We saw like, man, we have the same interest. And he had two turntables before anyone because you couldn't get the Technics 1210s anywhere. I always bought vinyls and went to him to listen to it because I didn't have a vinyl player. So he was just like, man, this music, you need to stop listening to this music. It's fucking annoying. It's just like, what the fuck is wrong with you? I have orange pants and like my hair in a Batman t-shirt that was glowing in the dark, standing and jumping in his room, and he was just sitting there smoking weed with his, you know, baggy pants and the whole swag that Steve kind of has, you know.
A lot of energy, you know. He was always very happy and very funny, and he always wanted to do stuff, you know. He had like spikes and buffaloes and, you know, this little rave kid.
And he made like hip-hop beats. I was just partying and kind of like coming into my puberty and drinking beer, and he just wanted to work. Then we went to my father's office. I had just got this CD. It's called Homework by Daft Punk. And I saw in Steve's face that something happened, and the same thing that happened to me when I was a kid and was listening to this techno.
When I heard this the first time, I was so shocked.
And he's just like, man, I don't know what happened, but I got a musical orgasm listening to this. I remember me and him, you know, coming into the same world, from hip-hop to techno, and we met.
Wow. What is it?
Do you smell it?
Not me.
Did I shit my pants, man?
What is it?
Wow. Är det jag som luktar eller?
Jag vet inte.
Kan du, är det min mun?
Nej. What is with your hat? Say something.
They crapped in your hat.
Is that?
Yeah, I think so.
No, it's not that. What, somebody ate dog shit?
Yeah, me. I think it's my mouth.
Did you eat dog shit?
Oof.
What is it?
Give it a go.
It's here. It's the fucking food.
In school, I discovered this music making software. Nerds, much like myself, would get together and make a demo, which meant a programmer would program the most advanced possible stuff he could on a screen, like make a square spin, and that would be like,
oh my God.
And then you would have a guy making music to this, and this was a demo. Basically, computer nerd music, demo music, is amateur versions of techno and trance, and the better I got and the better computers got, the more it started to sound like the real thing. You can find it, it's really fast and actually sounding quite amateurish.
I remember hearing the drums in that song. It was funky, it was groovy.
Well, we met at a restaurant. He was just some kid that came in and just like, why is he coming in like being all, why is he, hello, just,
oh my God, you are that guy. I just heard your song in Stonebridge Studios, amazing. And I remember Axel just looking at me like, what is this guy talking about? You know, he was like, whoa, 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 whoa.
He was very flamboyant. I guess the Italian in him was very apparent.
Well, I'm like, do you have a studio in Stockholm? Like, yeah. I'm gonna come down tomorrow. What's your number?
He's a bit pushy guy. He's a bit weird, you know?
I'm coming there at 3.
But you have to bear in mind, I came from south of Sweden and was very low key, you know, just very calm and Swedish, I guess.
I grab some music, I take Steve with me, and I go to the studio.
And you know, when you met somebody that was into dance music, it's like, if you all of a sudden let two dogs into a room, they start like smelling each other's asses and running around in a circle a little bit. We were like, wow, oh, you're also into dance music? Oh, wow, you know, so then we had to become best friends there at the spot.
Det är alltid samma hi-hat-klubb.
Det är sjukt. Där kom den.
Där, ja.
Say greyhound. Hey! How are you?
I'm the best.
Come over here. You want water?
I got brave.
Yes, we're just three normal guys from the suburbs in
what?
Stockholm.
Don't destroy the illusion. We're not normal. What are you talking about?
Think about it, the more you realize how big of a step dance music has taken. We could never go into Madison Square Garden 10 years ago. They would say we're fucking out of our heads. You know, and all of a sudden we can play any stadium in the world.
Talk. What do we do after this? You know, it doesn't get bigger than this. So that would mean repeating ourselves.
So we were like, the biggest change we could do right now is to stop.
Mm-hmm. So even though, yes, it's really early, and it might not be the best decision ever made in this world, it's still exciting.
It's going to be very sad, obviously, but also a little bit, finally, in a weird way.
You know, it is an end, but it's also a fucking amazing final.
The first time I heard Greyhound, just like that breakdown, I just lost it. It was like one of the best songs I've ever heard in my life.
Do you know that they opened the show with Greyhound?
Yeah, I did know that.
What are you gonna do when you hear that?
I'm gonna be losing my marbles. Scream my head off. Lose my mind as I usually do when I listen to music.
On your mark.
Det är pappa. En kulen natt, 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 en båt jag stider. På havets vågor och så skummet i det. En fisk jag såg och det var du.
Bra publik.
Ja.
Jävligt bra. Jävligt bra publik.
Nej, men alltså från typ 17 till 20 000 människor. Helt jävla bananas. Och adrenalin som pumpar och vi bara stod där och spelade trummor fan på scen. Och till ett så här tyst, sjukt, romantiskt hotellrum. Alltså man ska fan inte klaga, men det är någon typ av ångest som liksom, det blir så här, man får lite panik. Man måste typ wind down, man måste så här.
Jag tänkte på en sak. Undrar för vi kommer vara de där i de här MTV-programmen där det ibland sägs så här one hit wonders. Whatever happened to, så det är så här, Right Said Fred, liksom. De hade en låt och sen bara, vad gjorde de sen, liksom? But, do you remember this group, Swedish House Mafia? They had this one song, Don't You Worry Child. All three members now went off to do their own things, quite not as successful as the Don't You Worry Child single. And one of them went on to become a crack addict. Also, yeah, thanks, and one of them bought a lot of houses that he later had to sell.
Yeah.
And they tried to make a reunion tour. A few years, nobody came. So on our number 10 of One Hits Wonders, Swedish House Mafia. That, det kan hända. Ja, men det känns lite som jag sagt innan, som att vi får nyckeln till staden och sen bara, schysst, kasta iväg den. Det hade kunnat fortsätta att bli fetare.
It was very organic. It's more of the fans forming Swedish House Mafia than us sitting down with a piece of paper saying, shall we become Swedish House Mafia? We were a bunch of guys just having a great time and loving music, and we loved every second of it. That was the feedback from the shows, that was the comments afterwards, that was what people wrote about. It was like, they're having an amazing time up there. Then it became a festival, then it became a residency somewhere.
We started for fun, not knowing what we started, didn't think about what we started, we didn't plan anything.
Are you ready for some Swedish House Mafia?
We didn't see this as a long-lasting, you know, career. Even if we had a dream of, you know, the dream was that. But we were like, oh my God, we're gonna go abroad? Okay, this is gonna be a first, and that's how we felt with every gig. It's gonna be the first and the last gig, so we need to party our asses off.
Like, it was at the right moment in time, at the right moment for this music, at the right moment where we were with our music, we really hit the mother lode.
Just become this big machine, you know, a monster.
Today is a good day. Nej, fan alltså.
I sex år festar vi.
Konstant, fem dagar i veckan.
Fem dagar i veckan.
Två dagar reser man.
Och det var liksom inte bara alkohol som konsumerades, utan det var allt möjligt faktiskt som testades. Jag vaknade upp efter min födelsedag ett par år sedan. Det låg öl, spritflaskor överallt i min lägenhet. Allt möjligt var överallt helt enkelt. Folk överallt. Och jag vaknade upp och bara kände så här.
Det går inte.
Nu räcker det. Ut med alla människor som var där, förutom mina polare som jag känner. Och så sa jag så här. De som vill följa med mig, fetarna följa med mig. De som vill fortsätta med det här, radera mitt nummer nu på en gång. Och så hörs vi aldrig mer. Och så blev det. Och sen den dagen så har jag liksom aldrig... Jag har varit bra sedan den dagen.
Uh-oh, overhead shot.
Du började som en kul grej. Som inte det fanns några krav på någon. Det behövdes inga krav. Det som behövdes var att vi satt och ställde oss ihop och typ drack sprit och spelade. Liksom. Det var kraven liksom. Men just eftersom vi har plockats upp till den här nivån så krävs det helt andra saker än om inte vi ska ställas ut som fucking failures liksom. För mig är det skitviktigt att inte göra det. Jag menar bara att det är olika hur mycket vi satsar liksom på att det ska bli så.
Do you see the one in there?
Yeah, yeah. That's where the Fiona is. Abo, back lejonet. Look at the lion over there.
Okay, that's the sound I was afraid of. That's the sound I did not want to.
Don't bring green here, Kula.
Wait, they're going in with the cheetahs?
What? That's amazing. Are they dangerous?
I hope you guys are going to enjoy it. I hope there's no sissies amongst the lot, yeah?
Yeah, I'm a sissy. I can tell you. I admit, yeah, I'm a sissy. Yeah. I admit.
Like they.
Beautiful.
You can always leave if you don't like it.
You can walk straight back out. I'm going to be standing right here.
No.
You just stand and watch.
Nej, men jag vågar inte.
Kom,
men
jag har vågat.
Nej, nej, nej.
Jag ska se. I promise you.
Jag tar det.
You're cool.
Best way to get used to you is allow it to lick your scent. Keep your hand there. As it purrs, it tells you it's okay with you.
Okay, when can I take the hand away?
No, you don't take the hand away.
Now?
No, you can.
Oh, yeah? Okay.
But it's not a problem.
No, okay.
You did it though.
I didn't like it at all.
You didn't like it at all?
No, no, it's not my thing. Look.
Kommer du ihåg när jag sa för typ så här ett år sedan eller två år sedan? Jag bara, kommer du ihåg när jag sa så här, vi borde satsa på Swedish House Mafia 100%. Jag kommer inte ihåg om vi hade vår nidat eller vad det var. Men jag bara, vi borde satsa på Swedish House Mafia 100% och bara lägga ner vårt annat om vi ska satsa.
Ja, det sa du.
Och sen så bara, det, det hände ingenting med det där. Det var det som hade behövt hända för att det skulle kunna bli på riktigt liksom. Mm. Vi står och spelar för liksom 2 gånger 27,000 pers här. Om det skulle vara på samma nivå som de förtjänar på riktigt, så skulle vi bara satsa på det här. Vi skulle bara bli i studion flera månader, bara hej då till våra familjer. All, de skulle flytta till Sverige, vi skulle ha studio, alla skulle bli där och jobba.
Commitments menar du helt enkelt?
Yeah, we did.
Most thanks.
All right, guys, now a question on a lot of people's minds. I mean, is it? I mean, is it over? Or, I mean, is it maybe just the start of things? You guys just, you know, take a break, do your own thing, and maybe come back later on. What do you think?
How about you take this one?
Ja, alltså, jag tror att alla känner liksom lite samma sak eftersom vi alla har kommit överens om det här beslutet. Det är bara det, vi har inte pratat om det på samma sätt liksom.
De här några timmar i veckan som är helt fantastiska, det är magi och vi bara får nostalgi av alla låtar. Men sen är det tillbaka igen till det här liksom vakuumet som är hela tiden.
De gångerna vi har diskuterat det, så har det varit jävligt jobbigt liksom. Det har varit jävligt jobbigt och inte lätt till någonting liksom. Så att jag tror att därför så har det blivit en grej som vi bara stoppar under mattan så. Vi har bara stoppat under mattan och går runt och tycker det istället. Så är det bara. Så det är så det har blivit. Vem fan tycker om diskussioner och bråk liksom?
Det är ingen luft där inne, känner jag.
Ah.
Alltså vet du vad, den här borde inte heta One Last Door, den här borde heta One Last Clock. Vi bara klagar hela tiden, allting är så sönderlyxigt. Allting är helt, vi försöker hitta hela tiden någonting att klaga på. Det är helt sjukt alltså. Jag har aldrig varit med om maken. Ser du, nu klagar du igen.
Jag klagar inte, jag
bara med att fönstret. Nej men det är ju lite så här, fan man försöker hitta så här fel bara. Va? Vadå, vad är det här för bara så här klart? Må bra man.
We all grow up, it becomes different, you know, we don't hang out as much as we used to, you know, we live on different places, it's not the same anymore.
We are three people that have had individual agendas all the time, living in different parts of the world. We've not been able to give Swedish House Mafia that type of commitment that it deserves.
I guess it's for every, you know, friendship, and long-distance relationships. You know, it's tight in the beginning and then it just fades out. Du är sjuk jävla utsikt, är du? Billboard. Number one, Bruno Mars. Yay! Number seven.
What? Top 10?
It's crazy.
That's fucking wild, man.
That's unbelievable.
Cada uno de ustedes es reconocido. ¿Por qué decir adiós si han tenido gran éxito?
Why the decision to finish it with all this success with you?
It's about, you know, us doing a world tour and putting our other projects on the side for a while and saying hello and goodbye to our fans. And yeah, I mean, you can continue this maybe.
Yeah. Yeah. I think, we've had an amazing time and.
So like when it's like my father once said, if the cheetah approaches you, you have to push the cheetah down. And so that means that, you know, this became so big and we really, like Sebastian said, we wanted to finish it on the perfect level, you know? So just down cheetah, basically. Bueno, básicamente menciona que sería como que, como le decía a su padre alguna vez, ¿no? Que cuando el cheetah se te acerca, debes de... entonces es como que tienes que detener el...
De bara, shit, det är presidenten. Nej, det är tre DJs från Sverige. Okej, okay, precis.
I can't see shit.
Vänta, va? Men lägg av. Två,
fyra, tre. Jag kommer att spy. Jag kommer att spy.
Nej, kom igen. Skotta.
What the fuck? Where is it?
Jaha, det är någon springer runt, men.
We went to Australia, we rented a big house on the water, and we were like, we're gonna try and do Don't You Worry Child.
Abbo, vad vann
du? Är det vann nu?
Du har skojar du?
Ja, berätta.
33 grader de satt mig på nu, sa
hon.
Okej. Okay. Det finns fett med hajar här att man absolut inte ska bada.
Då gör vi inte det.
Man vill göra musik som låter som det här ser ut. Tror du vi kan göra musik som låter som det här ser ut?
Ja.
Bara, hur låter det här? Men ni ska nog uppnå dem. Dun 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 dun. En till upp då. En till upp.
Där. Fundera på att bara göra beatsen nu fan.
Fett som fan alltså.
Ja, det är skitfett. Får
de låna när de funkar?
Vi tar de här alla tre, bara lägg in dem så skönt. Alltså att...
att det spelar typ så.
Tid tar du tatuera
sig? Det beror på hur intensiv den är och hur många så. Den här tog ju skitlång tid, 4 timmar, för att då är flera lager på lager på lager med färger.
Men vilken blåst ska jag göra när vi har hyrt ett hus för 500 000 för att göra musik? Man kan ju tatuera sig i en label. Sist jag kollade.
Det här kommer göra ont. Nobody cares anymore. It's just that we are here. I left my family. He left his family. Steve left his family to come here to work and spend 5 days. Fuck that shit, man. I'm fucking tired of it, to be honest. Nothing is gonna happen. We're not gonna finish this record on this trip, to be honest. We are not. We need to be in the room and be creative and have fun. And, you know, when he comes, it's gonna be fucked. Of course, it hurts, man. I mean, it's just bad, man.
Yeah.
I mean, Ike's gonna speak to Steve when we have time, and if he doesn't really like understand it, then we have a huge problem. I mean,
du har inte skit på det. Du har inte en av dina bästa.
Skitsamma. Vi kör nu.
We felt that we've taken it somewhere in the right direction. But we didn't really get that far. And then we had to leave. At the same time, things were not really going so well with Swedish House Mafia.
We sit with the set tomorrow then. Mm. I mean, alltså jag vill inte så här skjuta fram någonting, men jag känner bara att det blir lite stressigt.
Because you're playing, you have to go.
Alltså jag kan skita i det. Alltså, det här är ju viktigare. Vår show är ju viktigare, men jag kan också göra det imorgon. Du kan sätta allting på mig imorgon. Jag ser på grejer.
There's a lot of stuff that everybody puts time and effort in that doesn't get credited for. If I go to 6,000 meetings about something, I'm not gonna put it up on a spreadsheet, you know. Seb dropped out of many studio sessions for reasons, but I've never accounted him for that and been like, oh, you didn't show up, so you're not gonna... I don't care. We're in this together.
You know what? We already had the best time with Swedish House Mafia, so why not just leave it there? Because we know that we're not gonna commit in the end of the day.
We don't want to have some sort of group that's half-assing it. I feel like nobody's pushing anything further. We don't want to mess up our friendship because we're angry at each other for not working enough. And then, actually, I dropped what I've been thinking for a bit. How about we quit Swedish House Mafia?
Forever in my heart. Assholes, you don't care about your fans. Something died in me. Faggots. Swedish House Mafia breakup is death of house music. You guys rewarding your fans in this matter, Frogetecken. Now I think my biggest hobby and biggest interest in life has died. Damn, I'm really fucking sad. Why? No, please don't.
The call I got was just like, we're gonna break up, fuck this shit. It's evil. It got so big, so fast. It's only real if you all mean it and you all really love each other. But the energy is no longer pure. And so One Last Tour was born.
The success of Swedish House Mafia is something no one can deny. You've released hit tracks, played sold-out arenas across the globe. Aren't you afraid of the future without SHM?
Not really. I mean, we are here now and enjoying the moment right now, and I'm just looking forward to what's going to happen next, you know?
There's no sort of big scheme or plan.
Exactly.
We've always done what we do and release our stuff and... play big events individually.
We just see this as an end of an amazing journey that we've done together as friends, and you know, it just feels right.
We all saw an end to the limbo. We were like, we need to do this. And we got really excited about ending the band. And that then led to us announcing Milton Keynes Bowl as our last show in the UK.
We said in an interview that, yes, we're premiering our last single there.
So that kind of set a time schedule to finish that fucker. Because if we told 60,000 people, they're going to hear Don't You Worry, Child at our show, better fucking finish it.
Great to meet you guys. You've played some massive shows. What makes this one so special?
It's our last Swedish House Mafia show in the UK.
Still on the subject of your tracks, can you confirm that your next one is going to be Don't You Worry, Child?
Yes.
Don't you worry, child. She has got a
number one in the UK.
iTunes number one in 42 countries.
Is that first ever UK number one?
Don't you worry, Charles.
We want everybody to sit down. Every single person out here, please sit down. When the time kicks in, we want you all to jump up. Are you ready?
Nice and warm here, huh?
Yes.
Oh, am I in Hawaii now? Is this Hawaii?
No, this is Malaysia.
Ah, Malaysia. You have this thing here also?
Yes.
Nice. Maybe you should sing a song also.
What up?
Yeah, we get this beautiful.
I'm okay. Thank you.
Nej, ta den.
Nej, jag får den.
Ja, men det är jättehövligt.
Ta på den, du måste ta på den.
Du måste. Det är ohövligt.
Ta på den, kolla om vi står där och gråter. Kommer gå hem och bara...
You know this is a theme park?
Oh, yeah?
Lots of rides at the back, if you can, but no time.
Oh, yeah.
Så skevt är den här grejen. Jag kan inte tänka mig att DJa när jag är 40, liksom. Jag kommer ju fortfarande ha med saker att göra, men jag kommer nog inte åka runt och spela. Så jag vet man ju inte hur länge hela scenen håller heller. Det får man ju se. Men allting har sitt slut.
Du vet, svettig jag somnade igår. Check Ryan ut mig till söms.
Är det så?
Ja, jag mår bra, man.
Jag mår bra.
Det är darka tider för mig, bara. Jag går igenom grejer. Det måste man göra ibland i livet.
Så.
Man måste rensa ut bara allt skit.
Trist.
Va?
Tråkigt.
Det kommer man sen, vi får se. Jag kommer till någon typ av så här stadie i mitt liv. Det jag vill ta i tur med saker och ting, förstår du vad jag menar? Ska vi sätta oss ner? Ska vi bara prata som vänner? Vi är fan vuxna människor. Vi har barn och familj allihopa. Vad fan håller vi på med? Är vi snorungar eller? Alltså, är vi fjortisar? Det här funkar inte. Det gör inte. Det lirar inte. Det gör faktiskt inte det.
Jag satsar 100% på Swedish House Mafia. Du vet, om inte man känner att alla är på samma page, liksom, då blir det jävligt tråkigt.
Säg det då.
Vi är män liksom, svårta. Om du har någonting att säga, säg det. Vad fan är problemet? Om du inte tar itu med ett problem på en gång, skit i det då.
Det tär ju på en, förstår jag menar. Men vill vi sätta igång det kriget nu? För det kommer bli krig.
It is what it is, man. You know, it's like, it's over, you know? So. Happened this year and made me realize that, you know, we're not best friends anymore. And that's the truth.
Normally we say, well, we've taken it as far as we want and so and so and so. Which is also true, but maybe we are not meant to be.
Have spoken.
This is further call for British Airways 223 to Washington. This flight is now boarding gate.
Hey.
Hey.
Vad stor. Vem är det?
Titta.
Want a flower?
Får aldrig åka bort.
What's up?
Jag älskar dig.
Haha, jag älskar dig.
Puss också. Annars?
Ja.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Indira Gandhi International Airport, New Delhi. The outside temperature is 27 degrees Celsius.
When was the first time I came to India?
2007.
It was so different and the energy was so amazing that I was just, it was just like, wow, this is something else. I have to come here more often.
The scene that we have in India today with millions of fans of dance music, this guy's fault. He started it.
An old friend of mine.
I think Axel is going to be surprised by the number of fans he has in India now compared to what was going on in 2007.
I would like to hear the go crazy and hear the music like it should do.
What's the time? We're looking through my father's eyes.
I mean, there's so many fucking people here to see them right now.
I don't know, I've got a special inner connect with them, so when I see them play, I get a special feeling, which I don't get, you know, when I see other DJs play, so.
We'll be right back.
happened tonight? Fuck, Axwell, Sebastian Ingrosso, and Steve Angelo killed the fuck out of this place.
Tonight was madness. I can't even speak.
We've been waiting for this for so long, and you have no idea.
I think we're going to say that, you know, it's probably the change of house movement in India, you know. Let's say it's come of age, you know, seeing about like 15, 20,000 people. You know, EDM has come of age in India. Let's put it that way.
Som bör trend också. Jag vill bara sticka dig.
Du mår ju bara sämre, eller? Skit i det.
Vad fan, lugna ner dig med dig här.
Jag vill bara ditt bästa.
Jag vet att du vill det, gubben.
Michelle, it's Amy. I really have got to be quick. Like, I'm in the middle of, like, literally running a festival. So, do you know, when can we do this call and how long will it be?
I'm basically the chairwoman of Swedish House Mafia. They are kind of like my second family, I suppose. I rang Steve Angelo. Can I book you? Can I do some stuff with you? He was like, sure. I also called Axwell. Steve introduced me to Sebastian. I just remember that they had swagger, especially Steve. I think they knew they could have swagger because they knew their music was so fucking good. They knew, you know, they knew what they were hearing externally, they knew what they were making, and they were kind of like, yeah, listen to that.
Så där och där.
Precis. Och du är?
Steve Angelo.
Okej, bra.
Kommentarer?
Fett, alltså.
Some of us made some mistakes, and the fact that we haven't been able to sit down and say sorry to each other is a tragedy. But I also think that even if we said sorry, I don't think it would fix it. And I think that we all want to be happy more than we want to be in Swedish House Mafia.
The members of Swedish House Mafia, Axwell, Steve Angelo, and Sebastian Ingrosso, to help us light the Empire State Building.
Hello, New York. This is actually the first time we visit the Empire State Building, and what an awesome way to visit it in, you know, having it lit up in the Swedish colors.
Liksom påsen börjar knytas ihop på något sätt, sakta, sakta. Det är liksom, det börjar bli liksom mer emotionellt än vad det var i början. För att det var inte riktigt nära slutet i början. Så även om det var sista gången vi spelade någonstans så hade vi så långt kvar. Så det började inte, det var inte en tankeställare efter varje gig.
Ångrar
du? Ibland.
Ibland.
Här går Sebastian Grosso runt. En lukna. I'm Swedish House Mafia.
Ta-da! Can we have a picture before you all go on and get
with your badass outfit.
You need to soft down a big way.
Hey, I'm saying it's good.
He said it's my best outfit ever, especially if I added oil. I mean, I'm just saying, that's not right.
Where was it proposed?
1, 2, oi!
Alex, vem är du?
Sebastian.
Vem är du?
We needed Axe to be the guy that always was there. And I, myself, pretty bad in the beginning, partying and like taking maybe Axe and Steve for granted a little bit. I can be with this fucking people here at this after party. They would fix that. And then 4 years later, I woke up and like, what have I done? But you know, this year and the year before, I've been working my ass off to prove to both Axe and Steve that, you know, I wanted to give something back to them for how many years they have been there and got my back.
She's like, but I'm Paris Hilton. I'm like, I don't give a fuck.
I don't give a call, man. I'm just so hyped. Wow, I'm gonna fuck this nightclub in the pussy.
In my mind, in my head, this is where we all came from. The dreams we have, the love we share. This is what we're waiting for.
Has never seen so much people smile.
Yeah.
In the crowd, they're like.
Plugs, it was great. I took a vodka shot because it was so great.
So you take a vodka shot?
Yeah, like this big.
Wow.
I needed to.
But if it continues like this, by the end of the tour, we'll be back to doing coke, just getting hammered all the time.
Yeah, I think so too. We got like the last show, like back to start again.
Why not?
Why the fuck not? Ashes here, so we can come and visit sometime, from time to time.
Say hi to the boys.
I will.
Steve Angelo.
I will.
And the best of luck.
And thanks so much for everything that you've done for everybody and the times you've given everybody, all right?
Hey, thank you, man. Thank you.
Det här är någonting som vi har gjort innan själva och som vi kommer fortsätta göra själva efteråt. Så det är egentligen inget konstigt så. Alla är olika liksom. Eller hur? Det är svårt att liksom... Det är slut nu i alla fall. Det här var det sista.
I feel that you have a lot of things between you three that is unsaid.
Yeah, it's probably never gonna be said either. Maybe in the future, you never know.
That when we be older, hopefully we meet each other in Ibiza or have some glass of wine or whatever and talk about it or not.
Jag tycker du ska säga Boen där som my name is this is Steve Angelo, this is Sebastian Grosso, we are still the Swedish House Mafia.
As I say that we are the Swedish House Mafia for one last time.
Nej, jag tycker vi har stilt
Swedish House
Mafia. Det är coolare. Mycket coolare. När du sa det sist, jag bara... Oof! Jag har distans som att jag stod i publiken och ville bassa alla.
Okej, det kommer bli mån.
Ja, det är så här... Oof, liksom.
Abo, spelar vi snart?
Yes.
Är du säker?
Jättesnart.
Är du 100?
Japp.
Vi borde gå upp dit och få lite vid med trummen. Jag måste slå lite på vinter. Bara komma in i rytmen lite.
Abo, vad stressad du är.
Be their friend, you know, obviously, but it's just not the same work-wise anymore. We had an amazing thing, and it's always sad to see things go and that you loved.
But look at us now, we've endured. We have this thing to look back on, and I think that's something that I would like to treasure. Gracefully, we will have a friendship, you know, we will have a graceful friendship.
It's sad, you know, when you think about it, but it's also very beautiful because we made something together and we were best friends and took this journey together and we've been there for each other. And so, I mean, it's not this little thing just in the end of not committing to things that breaks this up. It's just that we want to leave it. We don't want to end our friendship in a super bad way, you know? It could be worse, man. It could be flying chairs in the fucking faces and hitting each other with, you know, knives. But that's what we don't want, you know?
Say thank you for this great journey that you've given us, all the places we've been, all the love we got.
Words can't describe how I feel right now. I'm so
it's
sad.
Like, it's
I'm
like happy but sad.
At the same time.
Madison Square Garden, Barclays. I only go to my brother's that many times, you understand? The vibes are strong, energy.
I'm never getting over that ever, okay?
Never. Best night of my life.
It was sad to see them leave, though.
Well, they're gonna be fine, like,
they
so
meet individually, yeah, they're gonna be great, but it'd be nice if they stay together, but whatever. Maybe they'll come back and that.
I think they should listen to the people and stay together. Because everyone loves them, and they're just a great group of people.
I can die happy. I can die happy.
Time I used to look into my father's eyes in a happy home. I was a king, I had a golden throne. Those days are gone, now the memories on the wall. I hear the song from the places where I was born. Upon that hill across the blue lake, That's where I had my first heartbreak. I still remember how it all changed. My father said, don't you worry, child. See, heaven's got a plan for you. Don't you worry now. Yeah. Oh. Don't you worry now. There was a time I met a girl of a different kind. We'll rule the world. I thought I'd never lose her out of sight. We were so young. I think of her now and then. I still hear the songs reminding me of a friend. Upon that hill across the blue lake, that's where I had my first heartbreak. I still remember how it all changed. My father said, don't you worry, child. See, heaven's got a plan for you. Don't you worry. Don't you worry.